Welcome to the lesson on measurement systems standard form. In this lesson, we will talk about the basic measurement systems and how we can use them to solve our real-life problems. Now, by definition, we believe that many years ago, people decided to standardize how we measure things. We believe that people in markets needed some form of method to be able to compare and contrast different items and different commodities. So, the standard system of measurement was created mostly for length, weight, and capacity, that is, how much space something takes up. So in length, we have that 12 inches equal 1 foot, that 3 feet equal 1 yard, and that 5,280 feet equal 1 mile. Many of these we deal with on a regular basis. In weight, we have that 16 ounces equals 1 pound, and then we have that 2,000 pounds equals out to 1 ton. In capacity, we have that 8 fluid ounces equals 1 cup, 2 cups equal 1 pint, 2 pints equal 1 quart, and that 4 quarts equal 1 gallon. Again, many of these should sound very familiar in our everyday world. With regards to conversion, we know that multiplying and division can help us convert units and let us work with more manageable numbers. So let's take a look at a simple example on what exactly that means. Let's imagine that we're trying to think about how many ounces are there in 11 pounds. Perhaps you're trying to divvy up a certain amount of meat or corn. So I would imagine 11 pounds times by the 16 ounces that are in each pound. The units of pounds will cancel out, leaving us with 11 times 16 ounces, which will give us 176 ounces. So in total, in 11 pounds after multiplying, there are 176 ounces in those 11 pounds. Overall, converting helps us figure out the units that we need to know. But from time to time, we're going to have to be able to convert across multiple units. And by step assessing my units and my conversion rates, we should be able to figure it out. So look at the example of how many inches are there in 3 miles. I first must imagine and I must assess the fact that in every mile, I have 5,280 feet. So I'll take 5,280 and times it by 3, because this is going to give me the total amount of feet that I have. And from feet, I can work towards getting inches. So 5,280 times 3 is going to give me 15,840. Now that I have the amount of feet, I can times it by 12, because for every foot, I'm going to have 12 inches. So 15,840 times 12 will give me a final answer of 190,080 inches. So there are 190,080 inches in 3 miles. Well, I can go backwards and start from a small unit and go towards the big unit. How many tons are in 108,000 ounces? So I'm going to go from ounces to pounds first, and I'm going to divide that amount of ounces by 16 to figure out how many pounds I have available. So 108,000 divided by 16 will give me 6,750 pounds. Well, there are 2,000 pounds in every ton, so to find out the amount of tons that I have, I'll take the 6,750 and divide it by 2,000. After doing this math, I arrive at my answer at 3.375 tons. So there's 3.375 tons in that initial amount of 108,000 ounces. How many gallons are there in 188 pints? Might have to go across several units here. I'll divide the amount of pints by 2, because there are 2 pints in every single quart. So 188 divided by 2 will give me 94. So now I'm at 94 quarts. Well, there are 4 quarts in every gallon. So I'll take 94, divide it by 4, and get an answer of 23.5. So in the 188 pints I had available at the beginning, there are 23.5 gallons in that amount. The connection here is very strong. We live in a world where we're dealing with information in gigabytes and megabytes, and we need to convert those. Also thinking about pricing per unit and how much things cost.